Good afternoon, everyone. So we are at the end of antenna parameters. So I think you are all familiar about previous video lectures. So in previous video lecture, we stopped at directivity and resolution. So resolution equal to half of the Fresnel beam width. Suppose for example, for an particular antenna, if Fresnel beam width equal to 2 degree, Fresnel beam width equal to 2 degree, so that antenna has resolution of 1 degree according to that. So similarly, the product of two principal planes, theta planes and pi planes, may also be termed as antenna beam area. So beam area. So therefore, based upon this condition, number of radio transmitters or point sources to be estimated that n equal to 4 pi by beam area, simply total beam area or beam solid angle. So directivity equal to 4 pi by ohm A, so which is ideally for your respective thing. So now you are all watching on your screens. So you are that is antenna apertures. So antenna apertures is a different topic. Antenna apertures is a different topic from previous one. That according to that antenna apertures, generally this aperture is simply called when the antenna is looking from receiving condition. So that's why the concept of aperture is mostly simply introduced by considering the particular receiving antenna. So this is the concept of aperture, and this is the concept of aperture where most of the receiving antennas has their own criteria, their own mechanism to indicate that antenna apertures. For example, if the receiving antenna is an rectangular electromagnetical horn that positioned in the field of a uniform plane wave as shown in the figure, so according to our pointing vector knowledge, according to our pointing vector theorem, power density of the plane wave indicated by capital S, watts per steradian, watts per square meter of the particular area. Simply what we can say that this is the aperture, this is the physical aperture of the horn that is represented in the square meter. This is the physical aperture of the horn. This is the physical aperture of the horn that is this is the physical aperture of the horn that is immersed. This is the physical aperture of the horn that is immersed in the particular thing. So if that horn extracts the power, if the horn is here nothing but an antenna. Here we are positioning some antenna. That antenna has horn family. So if the horn extracts all the power from the wave over its entire physical aperture, then the total power, then the particular total power absorbed from this wave can be represented by power P equal to square of that incident field divided by corresponding impedance offered by this antenna multiplied with the physical aperture. So here we are developing some one equation called P equal to, here we are developing some equation called P equal to E square by Z. P equal to E square by Z multiplied by physical aperture. Nothing but physical aperture has directly proportionality to power incident, that is the power density of the plane wave. So in antenna apertures, physical aperture is simply called what is the shape of the particular antenna. Simple. If the antenna has a horn shape, physical aperture equal to horn. If the antenna equal to rectangle shape, physical aperture equal to rectangular aperture. If the antenna has a conical structure, physical aperture equal to conical aperture. So that is nothing but physical aperture helps. Physical aperture helps to provide the output visuality. In which way the antenna is visible? In which way the antenna is visible from outer side direction? That is represented here, antenna aperture. If the antenna has a square, square aperture. If the antenna has a rectangle, rectangular aperture. If the antenna has conical, that is called conical aperture. So from this knowledge, the receiving power, simply power density, can be represented by, why? Because all the direction of propagation of plane wave equal to in elevation plane, that is the elevation plane, xz direction. Therefore, this is the plane angle, this is the plane angle, this is the plane angle. So your cross-sectional electromagnetic horn, that is the plane wave incident on horn, having the physical aperture, a physical. So from this antenna, total power density can be calculated as E square by Z into a physical. So that equal to your S multiplied by a physical. So plane wave incident on electromagnetic horn of physical aperture, a physical. So what is the conclusion here we are obtaining? Electromagnetic horn may be having an aperture that total power is extracts from the what is passing wave. What is passing wave equal to through that wave proportionality to that aperture or area of its mouth. Clear? So the field response of the antenna is not uniform across the aperture because the field is at side boundary walls must equal to be zero. Why the field equal to zero at the neighborhood of the walls? Nothing but here the field excitation, is always in Z direction, XZ plane. Therefore, here we are writing the sentence because field at the side walls must be zero. Therefore, effective aperture of the horn less than the physical aperture. So here we are defining one definition. Here we are defining one definition or formula that equal to aperture efficiency. Very popular short answer question from this unit. So aperture efficiency defined as ratio of effective aperture to physical aperture. For example, if the person having, suppose for example, 6 feet long. So therefore physical dimensions of the particular person equal to 6 feet. So out of 6 feet, if the effectiveness equal to 5 feet only, that effective value equal to 5, nothing but if the paper, for example, we are defining effective aperture. It is the effective aperture out of total dimension of the antenna utility, the amount of area that used for the radiation concept is called effective aperture. Denominator, you are already has physical aperture. Physical aperture, effective aperture, simply called antenna aperture efficiency. So this antenna aperture efficiency may be brought that equal in the previous expression power. So power density equal to square of the field divided by intrinsic impedance of the medium 377 multiplied by AE. So write down in your notebooks. So in this concept, power density acquired by our antenna aperture equal to P equal to E square Z naught divided by AE, where Z naught equal to intrinsic impedance of the medium 377. So what is the updated equation or modified equation for above equation? Assuming if the uniform field in the far field at a distance is smaller, therefore what is the power radiation? So that power radiation equal to across the uniform radial far field, R indicating far field, multiplied by square of the distance from the origin to the particular antenna, that equal to called, this is the alternating form. Already we mentioned there are various modified expressions for each equation in our antenna subject. Therefore, power density may also be expressed in formula E square divided by Z multiplied by R square into beam A, that is the beam solid angle. This is the second example. So what is the ohm A here? Beam area or beam solid angle. So from this example, what is the aperture beam area relation? What is the relation between aperture to beam area is simply that product of aperture, that is the effective aperture multiplied by beam area, that is simply called it as square of the wavelength. With another relation, what is the relation for directivity from the aperture? So directivity equal to 4 pi into effective aperture by lambda square. This is already well-known formula, D equal to 4 pi AE by lambda square. So from this one, you are obtaining effective aperture equal to D into lambda square by 4 pi. Here, if the D equal to for isotropic antenna, directivity always equal to 1. Therefore, lambda square by 4 pi, approximately you are getting 0.0796 lambda square. So what is the key point? What is the key point or what is the terms we are getting here? All lossless antennas must have effective aperture equals or greater than that of this one. That is why we are calling it as here isotropic antenna with the directivity equal to 1. So by that reciprocity theorem, there are various, already we mentioned the directivity of the particular pattern, that equal to your directivity equal to P of theta comma phi, that is the maximum power density to average power directivity in the pattern. Directivity in terms of the patterns, 4 pi divided by beam area. Directivity in terms of the apertures, 4 pi into AE by lambda square. So these are all the alternating equation from our this one. So that is simply the antenna aperture. So detailed antenna apertures we are able to watch in upcoming lectures also. There are effective aperture, physical aperture, scattering aperture, loss aperture. There are various. In this slide, we are able to familiar effective aperture and physical aperture. So now we move on to antenna efficiency. So the total antenna efficiency used to take an account losses at the input terminals and with the structure of the antenna should be derivable. So this is the antenna reference terminal, source, transmission line, antenna. If you are considering, this is the part of the antenna. For this part of the antenna, the input side equal to called input terminals and output side equal to called output terminals. So in the output and input, you are able to clear all the estimated values, all the estimated values of your respective thing. Therefore, you are able to visualize this input and output values. So that is simply called here antenna reference terminals. But in the second explanation here, reflection or so reflection, conduction and direct linked losses. So from this one the reflection and the conduction and the dielectric losses are we able to estimate. So here we are able to estimate the reflection, conduction and conducting losses that we are able to clear all the respective things in such a way that their individual values should be dropped down. So when you are taking, so when our antenna is taking as a reference condition, so this is the condition where our input terminals are to be knocked by your output reflection and conduction losses. So based upon our knowledge, the total antenna efficiency, similarly for hardware equipment subject, for example, rectifiers efficiency, transformers efficiency. So in this component, here we are having the particular antenna efficiency. So that equal to total number of antenna efficiency used to take in an account losses at the input terminals and within the structure of the particular antenna. Clear? Understand? So that antenna efficiency here represented by reflections due to the mismatching conditions of transmission line and that antenna. Similarly, I square R losses in general. So the overall efficiency can be evaluated by total efficiency equal to product of reflection efficiency, conduction efficiency, dielectric efficiency. Understand? Conduction efficiency, reflection efficiency, and this one, conduction efficiency. So therefore, note down in your books, next equation, E naught total efficiency equal to reflection, conduction, dielectric. So E naught equal to ER, EC, ED. Understand? So ER equal to reflection, EC equal to conduction, ED equal to dielectric. So when that is reflection equal to 1 minus of coefficient, that is the reflection coefficient eta. So that is the voltage reflection coefficient at input terminals of the antenna. So already voltage reflection coefficient you have formula z in minus z naught divided by z in plus z naught, where z in is the antenna input impedance, z naught is the characteristic impedance of the transmission line. Z in equal to antenna input impedance, z naught equal to line characteristic impedance. Therefore, from this example, we familiar about voltage standing wave ratio 1 plus tau divided by 1 minus tau, where tau equal to voltage reflection coefficient. Voltage reflection coefficient. Generally, these terms are used to evaluate. The meaningful values that equal to usually conduction and dielectrics are very difficult to compute, but they can be determined experimentally. Therefore, total efficiency can be compressed, total efficiency can be simplified in the form of E naught equal to ER multiplied by ECD, but ECD equal to 1 minus tau square. The value for 1 minus tau square equal to reflection efficiency. So ECD equal to ERD equal to total efficiency. So total efficiency equal to ER multiplied by ECD. Therefore, ECD equal to 1 minus tau square, where ECD equals to antenna radiation efficiency, which is used to relate the gain and directivity relation. So now let me move on to next slide, effective height. Clear what we discussed up to now? The directivity, what is the resolution? Did the resolution here? The resolution formula equal to Fn BW by 2, that equal to Hp BW, and the relation beam area equal to product of theta plane and phi plane, Fn BW by 2 multiplied by Fn BW by 2. So number of radio transmitters equal to 4pi divided by omega. So directivity equal to 4pi divided by omega, where d equal to number of radio transmitters. Similarly, we learned about antenna apertures. So antenna apertures are divided into physical aperture, effective aperture, loss aperture, scattering aperture. So from this slide, we learned about antenna efficiency. Antenna efficiency equal to formula ratio of effective aperture to physical aperture. So from this slide, we noticed that various interrelationship between our parameters. So directivity equal to 4 pi AE by lambda square. Directivity equal to 4 pi divided by beam area. The directivity equal to 4 pi into effective aperture divided by lambda square. You should throw all the equations. You should throw all the definitions, whatever you are learning, whatever you are watching on your screens. So separately note down in your notebooks, practice daily. So why? Because while writing end examinations of AWP, these equations helps you a lot to get good number of marks. So later we completed antenna efficiency, that antenna efficiency equal to product of reflection, conduction, dielectric. Now we move on to effective height. To understand the effective height of the particular antenna, Here we draw a simple diagram for half wave dipole. So this is the half wave dipole. For a half wave dipole, maximum current is available at the center of the half wave dipole, and from here you are obtaining the average current equal to like at approximately 0 point, that is the dipole with the sinusoidal current distribution, same dipole with length equal to 0.1 lambda. Therefore sinusoidal distribution converted into triangular current distribution in our programming lab, or in our synthesis simulation results. Therefore here you are watching on your screen the topic definition parameter. Next parameter, note down effective height. Next parameter, effective height. So here we are representing the effective height in letter small h. Units are be measurable in meters. This effective height may be understand the particular antenna is related to the aperture. When you are linked the antenna, with your aperture, automatically your effective height also be comes into the account. Therefore, simply by multiplying that effective height with the incident electric field, it is incident electrical field, capital E, volts per meter, with the unchange in the particular polarization. Therefore, automatically the induced voltage will be monitored at the boundary. Induced voltage is noticed at the terminals of the particular antenna. Therefore, now we are developing an equation that induced voltage equal to H into capital E. Very important equation for our problems. It is V equal to HE. So according to this, the effective height may be defined the ratio of induced voltage to incident field. So now in your notebooks, write to put subheading topic antenna parameter is effective height. Effective height definition equal to ratio of induced voltage to incident field. Formula or equation, H equal to capital V by capital E. Units are meters. So to illustrate this effective height, consider the particular example when vertical dipole, when the dipole of the length L equal to lambda by 2, that is placed in the incident field having value capital E, for example, shown in the figure. If the current distribution of the dipole wave is uniform, that their effective height should be equal to 1. For example, if the actual current distribution, however, is nearly sinusoidal with average value of 2 divided by pi, therefore the value equal to 0.64. Therefore, that effective height equal to 0.64. And it is assumed that antenna is oriented for maximum response. So therefore, with this knowledge, this information is placed in the picture that dipole of the length L equal to lambda by 2. So for lambda by 2, So dipole having the length L equal to lambda by 2, therefore automatically you are having the relation that your sinusoidal distribution should be available in the particular value. So if we are assuming, what is your assumption is that if the dipole is used at a longer wavelength, so that it is only for 0.1 length. Therefore, the conclusion is current tapers almost linearly from the center feed point to zero at the end in a triangular distribution. Therefore, the average current is half of the maximum, so that effective height is 0.5L. What is the effective height? 0.5L. Therefore, another way for defining this effective height is to consider the transmitting case and equate to the effective height of the physical height. Therefore, write down the equation for effective height second form, that equal to integration 0 to maximum height, HP is the availability height, that is the physical height, 0 to physical height, current driven on the particular antenna A of Z multiplied by DZ. So therefore, effective height equal to 1 divided by I naught degradation 0 to HP I of Z DZ, that equal to I average divided by I naught, physical height. So therefore, HP equal to physical height, HE is the effective height, and I average equal to average current. So it is apparent that effective height is a useful parameter for transmitting the type of the antenna. So if it is apparent that effective height is an useful parameter for transmitting the most of the installed fabricated, what is the tower type antenna equal to very tall antenna like mobile towers, etc. So the parameter effective aperture is more general application for all the antennas. So therefore, the two internal relationship shows the important value here. So another alternative form for effective height, equal to HE equal to HE equal to 2 square root of RRAE by Z naught and AE by Z naught. So let me stop normal class here. We have another seminar continuation by this one.